Hey everyone, this is Richard Walker from Lucidate. In this video, the second in our series of six on fine-tuning large language models, we'll explore a powerful approach to working with the vast array of language models available on platforms like Hugging Face. By leveraging the Langchain library, you'll be able to tap into these models and generate text for various applications of your own. Hugging Face is a treasure trove of pre-trained language models, offering a wide range of options for different tasks and domains, from general purpose models like GPT to specialized models for translation, computer vision, and more. Hugging Face has you covered, but how can you effectively utilize these models in your own projects? Enter Langchain, a game-changing library that simplifies the process of working with LLMs. Langchain acts as a bridge between you and the models, providing a high-level interface for creating chains of prompts and language models. With Langchain, you can easily integrate Hugging Face models into your workflows and build powerful AI applications. Today, we'll do a code walkthrough and see just how easy it is to interact with these models with just a few lines of Python. Before we dive into the code, let's quickly set up our environment. We'll need to install the required libraries such as Langchain and Langchain Community. We'll also need to obtain a Hugging Face API token to access the models hosted on their site. One of the key aspects of working with LLMs is prompt engineering. Crafting effective prompts is crucial to guiding the language model's generation process. Langchain introduces the concept of prompt templates, allowing you to define the structure of your prompts with placeholders for user input. By mastering prompt engineering, you'll be able to unlock the full potential of the models available on Hugging Face. Langchain offers flexibility in how you interact with Hugging Face models. You can choose to use a remote API endpoint, leveraging the computing power of Hugging Face's own servers, or run the models locally on your own machine using the Hugging Face pipeline. We'll explore both approaches in this video and discuss the benefits and considerations of each. First, let's see how to use a remote Hugging Face API endpoint. We'll initialize a Hugging Face endpoint with the desired model, in this case, a Mistral 7B model. We can specify parameters like temperature and maximum length to control the generation process. In this code, we set up a prompt template and use a very simple chain of thought prompt to nudge the LLM to come up with a more thoughtful and considered response. We'll ask the LLM a question on football, soccer, to the rest of the world. As you can see, it comes up with a considered, if somewhat undefinitive, answer. Next, we'll demonstrate how to run a Hugging Face model locally using the Hugging Face pipeline. We'll load the Google FLAN T5 large model and create a pipeline for text generation. This approach is useful when you want to run the model on your own machine, maybe for security purposes or to be cost effective. Here, we'll invoke this model with a simple question without any sophisticated prompting. You see the answer. We still have our cloud-based model available, and we'll ask it a similar question. The difference in quality of answers can be attributed both to differences in the models, as well as the difference in prompting. Recall, the first model was prompted with a quasi-chain of thought prompt. Now, while pre-trained models offer a great starting point, you may want to adapt them to your specific use case. In future videos, we'll explore how you can fine-tune these models using your own datasets or custom datasets from Hugging Face. Fine-tuning allows you to specialize the models of your particular domain or task, unlocking even more accurate and relevant text generation. By mastering the techniques covered in this video, you'll be empowered to incorporate the vast array of language models from Hugging Face into your own projects. Whether you're building chatbots, content generators, or any other text-based application, Langchain and Hugging Face provide the tools you need to succeed. Now we've covered the basics of working with Hugging Face models using Langchain, let's take a look at how we can create user-friendly web applications to interact with these models. Here we've developed a Streamlit web application that provides an intuitive user interface for engaging with language models, both locally and in the cloud. Building a web application is essential for making AI accessible to a mainstream audience, while command line interfaces and hard coding prompts into our Python scripts are useful for developers, AI enthusiasts, and testing our ideas, they're not practical for the average end user. By creating a user-friendly web interface, we can empower a wider range of people to leverage the power of language models in their own applications and projects. Our Streamlit web application leverages the capabilities of Langchain to seamlessly integrate with Hugging Face's models. Langchain's high-level abstractions and utilities make it easy to load and interact with these models, whether they're hosted locally or in the cloud. By building on top of Langchain, our web application inherits its flexibility and robustness. Let's take a closer look at the code structure of our Streamlit web application. The code is organized into several classes, each with a specific responsibility. Firstly, LucyEnvConfig. This class loads environment variables, such as the Hugging Face API. It ensures that sensitive information is kept separate from the main code base. LucyModelSetup. This class is responsible for setting up the language models. It can set up models hosted in the cloud using Hugging Face Endpoint and local models using Hugging Face Pipeline. It abstracts away the complexities of model initialization and provides a consistent interface for working with different models. LucyModelSelector. This class manages the available language models. It initializes both local and cloud model setups and provides methods to list the available models and retrieve the selected model. It acts as a centralized hub for model management within the application. LucyQueryExecutor. This class handles the execution of queries on the selected language model. It takes the user's input, invokes the model, and returns the generated response. It acts as a bridge between the user interface and the underlying language model. Finally, LucyStreamlitApp. This class implements the main Streamlit web application. It sets up the page layout, displays chat messages, and handles user interactions. It allows users to select a language model from a drop-down menu and maintains the chat history using Streamlit session state. These classes work together to create a cohesive and interactive web application for engaging with language models. The code for both the command line version I showed previously and this Streamlit web application are available in the Lucidate GitHub repo called Lucidate Finetune. You can find the code at the URL on your screen. There's also a link in the description. We encourage you to explore the code and experiment with multiple different models. As we've seen, developing a user-friendly interface is crucial for making AI applications accessible to a mainstream audience. While the underlying models and APIs are powerful, they can be overwhelming for non-technical users. By investing in a small amount of UI development, we can create intuitive and engaging experiences that allow users to harness the potential of AI without getting bogged down in complex technical details. In this video, we've explored how Streamlit web applications build on top of the foundations of Langchain to provide a user-friendly interface for interacting with LLMs hosted on Hugging Face. By leveraging the power of Langchain and the flexibility of Streamlit, we've created a platform that empowers users to build their own local or cloud-based AI applications. We encourage you to dive into the code, experiment with different models, and explore the possibilities of AI-powered applications. Remember, the key to making AI accessible lies in creating intuitive and engaging user experiences. Stay tuned for future videos where we'll delve deeper into fine-tuning models, exploring optimization techniques like LoRA, and demonstrating how we can build and evaluate fine-tuning datasets for our models. Until then, happy coding and building with AI.